Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are here for weeks 31 through 34 for a bump date. Let's hop on into what's been going on. Okay, so it's been a hot minute, guys. I have not recorded a video for a few days. I've been feeling super pregnant, getting ready for the holidays, and I had to stop Vlogmas. Just was too much going on. But I want to get you guys caught up because right now, today, I am 35 weeks pregnant and there is a lot going on. So I need to fill you in. Today especially, you guys, the Braxton Hicks and the contractions are becoming more intense and more real. Today they have felt, last night they were really crampy. I've been having lots of Braxton Hicks for the past, I would say, 6 weeks, but in the last like three, they've become more and more intense as each of the weeks have gone on. So the last time I talked to you guys, I was telling you that it was pretty much just my carpal tunnel that was bothering me at that point. Oh, the carpal tunnel has actually gone away for the most part. Ooh, but the carpal tunnel has actually gone away for the most part. But like when I'm driving, my hands will still go numb, or like when I wake up in the morning, or if I like sleep on my hands or like raise my hands too high, they will go numb. But I can definitely tell that the fluid retention is starting to increase, especially just in the past couple of days. I have avoided it this far, which is super great, but I can feel it come in slowly but surely. Weight gain, I have gained a little bit more weight because of that fluid retention. I am sitting right around 25 pounds gained, which is where I wanted to max out my weight gain for this time, but I am okay with that, knowing that I only have about 5 weeks left, and I know I can gain about a pound-ish a week from here on out. So if I can just gain less than I did last time, which was 100 pounds, I'm A-okay with that. Back to those contractions. They have been getting really intense. Today on my way home from work, they were very like Charlie horse-like and really painful, not crampy period type contractions that you experience during labor, but they nonetheless were very uncomfortable, very painful, and really caught me off guard and made me gasp out loud, actually. The baby was moving at the same time as those like Charlie horse type contractions. I think he like put a heel like right to my stomach, right in the spot where I was having this contraction. So it was really intense. But yeah, so my tummy is really tight. I feel like my body is really getting ready now. I'm starting to kind of retain those fluids. My hips, everything feels a lot looser, and I can definitely feel that he's wiggling down into position. And he is still really active right now at 35 weeks, which is good. He's really active, which tells me he's gonna be able to keep up just fine with his big sister. I can definitely tell that it's getting close, you guys. I think if I had my predictions, I'd say he'd come right around 39, 40 weeks, but we will see. Now, as the weeks get closer and closer, I'm going to fill you guys in a little bit more as to what I plan to do for my labor and delivery. So I do have a little bit more of a plan for labor this time, or trying to put myself into labor, I should say. So I will be sharing some of those tips with you along the way. I'm gonna start out by sharing that I am going to start using the evening primrose oil. So I'm going to start orally taking that this week. And then starting at 37 weeks, I will start inserting two pills vaginally each night, because I did the same thing with my daughter Kaya and I barely tore. I had like two stitches and she was a 9 pound baby and was 22 and a half inches long. I know I've said that in like all of my other videos that she was a huge baby, but I only had two stitches with her, and I account a lot of that to the fact that I was using evening primrose oil along with my epidural not working, so I actually was more aware of when to push, and we really let her labor down. I think the combination of those things helped me to not tear as badly as other first-time moms. All right, fluid retention, Braxton Hicks contractions and real contractions, and a little bit more weight gain. You guys, that is what's been going on. Lots of contractions, there's lots of action. You can just kind of feel when your body's getting ready. And my body is definitely getting ready to bring this sweet little baby boy into the world. I cannot wait. All right, you guys, that is going to wrap it up for this bump date. My battery is flashing. I'm hoping to squeeze in a little, quick little bump shot for you guys. Thank you so much for tuning into today's video. You guys are officially caught up to where I am. I am 35 weeks pregnant, and I cannot wait to share some of the videos I have planned coming up for you. I've got a nursery tour, my bedside nursery tour, and some of the postpartum stuff that I'm gonna start prepping, along with the birth vlog. I can't wait. I am so excited. All right, you guys, well, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy whatever you celebrate. You're so sweet. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel before you leave and join our little family here on YouTube and give this, give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And stay tuned for baby updates and the last 5 weeks of this pregnancy. Oh, yay! Okay, say bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye. Here's the bump in all her glory. All his glory, I should say. I'm super excited. He's getting big, is he not? Seriously, look at me, you guys.
Ouch!
You gonna give him a kiss? You're gonna take him out? Say, I'm ready to meet you.
I can make you a little closer, make you boo boo.
What the heck? Oh, that Charlie horse right here. Oh my goodness sakes. Aren't you guys? There you go. 35 weeks today. All right. Bye, guys. We'll see you very, very soon. Okay.